I forgot to use sunscreen before I left the house, but I'm already outside. I've got sunscreen in my car, but I won't be able to wait 20 minutes for the sunscreen to dry. Is there any point in using sunscreen at all? What do you think, Pingu? Hey guys, welcome to DocUnlock, where we help you learn more about your body so that you can make better decisions about your health. Today, Pingu and I are going to help you learn about sunscreens. We're going to answer some common questions and also bust some myths as we go. Let's get cracking. First question. I don't need to use sunscreen all the time. So this one's true. When the UV index is more than 3, that's when it's recommended to use sunscreen. Second question. Sunscreens shouldn't be used for babies. So this one is true. Kids less than 6 months of age tend to have very immature skin. So when you put sunscreen on them, there is a possibility that the ingredients in sunscreens can irritate their skin. So to protect young babies from sun damage, the best way is to hang out in the shade or use UV protective clothing. Next question, sunscreen doesn't work unless you've waited for 20 minutes. So this is an awesome question and something that I've actually thought about. In theory, technically, sunscreen is ready to go straight out of the bottle. The ingredients don't need to have anything done to them for them to protect you from UV. But the reason why manufacturers talk about this 20-minute rule is because the sunscreen works best when it's applied evenly and there's a dry, even film on your skin. But that doesn't mean that even if the sunscreen hasn't had that time to dry, that it's providing no protection. It's just providing less effective protection. So if you're outside and you've forgotten your sunscreen and you've got some in the car, go ahead, use it. Because any amount of sunscreen is going to be better protection than no sunscreen at all. Question number 4. Physical sunscreens don't need to be reapplied. Well, this one's clearly false, but I can understand why people may ask this question.
Hi, Pingu.
The reason why this question comes up is because there is this understanding that the ingredients in chemical sunscreens do break down when they're exposed to UV. But it is thought that the physical sunscreens, like zinc and titanium-based sunscreens, well, those ingredients don't break down. But the issue is that reapplying sunscreen has got nothing to do with the breakdown of the actual ingredients. It's because sunscreen rubs off your skin or drips off in the sweat. So it's not because it's actually breaking down that you need to reapply. Regardless of the sunscreen ingredient, zinc, titanium, chemical sunscreen, you still need to reapply regularly to get the best effect. Question number 5. Ingredients from chemical sunscreens are absorbed and cause hormone problems. Again, this is such an awesome question, because it has a sort of a half-half answer, half true, half false. So first thing to get out of the way is that physical sunscreens, those with zinc and titanium, don't have any absorption into the body, none at all. It just sits on the skin and doesn't pass through the epidermis. But the ingredients in chemical sunscreens do have some absorption. In fact, I think there's a study which had 32 people and they applied sunscreen for a week. The researchers took samples of urine and blood and found that there were detectable levels of sunscreen. But the thing is, absorption is not the same as having a biological effect. So in that same study, when the researchers tested the hormone levels, they were exactly the same as before, no change. So just because there is some absorption of chemical sunscreens doesn't mean it's actually having any harm for the body. There's another study that's often quoted on the internet, which is a rat study. So in this study, rats were actually fed astronomical doses of these sunscreen ingredients, and they found that the womb size or the uterus size increased in these rats. There was a subsequent paper which discussed the study and actually calculated how much sunscreen you would need to use to get that same level. And they calculated that with regular sunscreen use, humans would need to apply sunscreens for something like 277 years to get the same dose. So again, not really relevant to what we're talking about because we're just not using sunscreen in that kind of dose range. But if you are worried about hormone effects from sunscreens, the simple solution is to use physical sunscreens, the ones with zinc or titanium, because they don't have any absorption at all, so nothing to worry about. Next question. Makeup protects you from the sun. Well, Pingu and I don't know much about makeup because we're ruggedly handsome as it is. Yes, what happened, girl? But there is some truth to this. Foundation makeup especially can provide some sun protection, but it's usually anywhere up to SPF 4 and 5, which is not usually enough for most people. There are some makeup products which include up to SPF 15 sunscreen ingredients, so that might be a good choice. Just remember that some of those cosmetics don't have broad spectrum protection. So if you can find a cosmetic makeup like a foundation, which is broad spectrum, that's going to be better than a UVB only protection. Okay, so question number 7. Sunscreens can cause heat burns. Well, this one's definitely a myth. Well, it's true that sunscreens have these ingredients which convert UV light into heat. I mean, the UV light that's absorbed has to go somewhere. But this is nowhere near as much heat as is required to get actual heat burns. So this one's clearly false. So Pingu's having had enough of recording. She wants cuddles. This is what her cuddle position. We call her Super Pingu, but we're gonna push on. Pingu, the next question is, I can't use sunscreens because I'm allergic to them. So this can be true for some people. People can react to the fragrance, sometimes the preservative, or even the sunscreen ingredient. The rate of this is actually quite low. So one study looked at about 24,000 people and found a 1% rate of allergic reactions to sunscreens. But if you have had an allergy to sunscreens, try using a physical sunscreen with titanium and zinc that minimizes preservatives and fragrances, because these tend to be better for sensitive skin. Pingu, the next one is, glass blocks UV, so I don't need to use sunscreen. So this one's a myth. I showed you in my vitamin D video how glass blocks UVB, but doesn't block UVA. So if you've got an office desk right next to the window, or you're going for a long car ride, then using a broad spectrum sunscreen to protect yourself from UVA is definitely worth your while. Next question, and question number 10. Using sunscreen causes vitamin D deficiency. This is a super interesting one. So, in theory, when sunscreens are used exactly in perfect experimental conditions, they block pretty much all UVB. And so in theory, that would lead to vitamin D deficiency. But here's the kicker. When they did trials to compare vitamin D levels in real-world use of sunscreens, they found that sunscreen actually had no effect on vitamin D. And there might be a few reasons for this. The ones that come to mind is that in real life, you don't actually use as much sunscreen as you need to completely block UV. And also, you don't tend to reapply frequently enough. So the fact that the skin is able to make vitamin D very quickly means that even with sunscreens, there's still going to be enough UV around for your skin to be able to make enough vitamin D. So definitely a myth. Sunscreens don't in themselves cause vitamin D deficiency. Okay, and we have question 11. Using sunscreens doesn't actually protect people from melanoma. So I don't know where this one came from, but it's clearly false. In fact, there was a very important randomized trial that found that sunscreens protect from invasive melanoma by 73%. That's huge. So definitely use sunscreens to protect yourself from melanoma. I will say that there are some forms of melanoma which are not related to UV, but that's very rare. 95% of melanomas are related to sunburns and UV. So that's it, guys. This is the last episode in the series on skin cancer and sunscreens. If you learned something new, please hit that like button and subscribe for more awesome videos. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.